So the first thing that you're going to do when you open up the Lazarillo app is create an account. This allows you to customize your experience on the app and save locations using the favorites feature.
Welcome. Sign in to start exploring.
It also ensures that your data is saved no matter what phone you use to log into the app. So to create an account, you can sign up with a direct login using pre-existing Google or Facebook accounts, or you can create a new account using a different email address. On iOS, you can also log in directly using an Apple account. So I'm going to go ahead and type in my email, username, and password to get started. Go ahead and grant any permissions requested by the app so that the app can function properly.
You are on Wickersham LN 2501, Austin TX.
Once you've finished creating your account, it's also important for you to go into your settings and grant permission for the app to use your location. On iOS, select Lazarillo in the settings menu. Under the location tab, make sure that you've selected while using the app. On Android, make sure that you've selected all the time. This will make sure that the app will continue to function in the background if you go to a different app. It's necessary for all of Lazarillo's navigation features to work properly. Exploration is one of the primary functionalities of the Lazarillo app. When you open Lazarillo, it immediately identifies your location and begins to dictate information.
You are on S Congress app, Austin TX.
It tells you where you are, as well as information about your surroundings, including the location of the nearest intersection or places of interest nearby.
Intersection West Johanna Street and South Congress Avenue, 59 feet behind you. Shop and service, Orange Salon, 124 feet to your left. Restaurant, Magnolia Cafe, 136 feet in front of you.
As you walk, the app will continue to update and inform you of nearby intersections and other important information about your surroundings.
Shop and service, Bird's Barber Shop, 167 feet to your left. Intersection South Congress Avenue and West Mary Street and East Mary Street, 42 feet to your left.
If you're riding in a vehicle, the app will detect your speed and automatically transition into vehicle mode. If you want to pause the exploration feature, you can simply select the Stop Exploration button in the top menu by touch or using a screen reader.
Exploration is stopped.
You can also create a custom configuration for the exploration feature by selecting the Category Filter button in the upper right corner of the app. You can create unique configurations for walking mode and vehicle mode, allowing you to hear updates about different locations in each transportation mode as needed. Once you're in the configuration menu, you can simply check or uncheck different categories of locations, which Lazarillo will then save automatically. You can also choose to select or deselect all categories of locations at once. The app will then begin to filter for these configurations while you're using the exploration functionality. If you want to search for a specific location, this can be done easily through the Lazarillo app.
You are on S Congress Ave 2001 to 2071, Austin TX.
You can browse nearby locations using the category icons on the Exploration tab, or search for a specific location using text or dictation. To use this feature with a screen reader, just activate VoiceOver on iOS or TalkBack on Android, and tap to hear the different categories.
Accessible locations, button. Find nearby transport locations, button. Find nearby banks and ATMs locations, button.
So I'm going to go ahead and select the shop category, and as you can see, our locations are listed here. Once you select a category, nearby locations will be listed according to distance, with the closest locations being listed first. The category feature will list locations in roughly a 1.5 to 2 mile radius of the user. If you want to search for a specific location or just one that's further away, you can do that using the search button in the upper menu of the app. Just select the search button and type or dictate the name of the location that you want to find.
5 places available.
Once you select a location, you can add the location to your favorites menu using the favorites button, or share the location using the share button.
Museum, Blanton Museum of Art, 4 miles to the north.
So once you select the location that you want to reach, Lazarillo provides you with a number of different options en route to your location. These options include tracking, walking, public transport, traveling by vehicle, and requesting an Uber. To use tracking mode, you can simply toggle the Track This Place button on your location screen.
Tracking started.
Using tracking mode, Lazarillo provides you with regular alerts about your distance from your location. This feature is most effective when you're already familiar with a route and you don't need turn-by-turn directions, or if you're traveling to your location on a bus and you need to know when to signal for the bus to stop.
Tracking finished.
To find a walking route, you can start by selecting the walking button on the location screen. Lazarillo will provide you with a choice between getting your route through Google Maps or using Lazarillo's custom mapping software. We recommend selecting Lazarillo's mapping software as it's optimized to function alongside the Lazarillo app and allows for Lazarillo to provide turn-by-turn directions while you move along your route. If you select Google Maps, that app will provide its own turn-by-turn directions, which may overlap with separate directions being given by Lazarillo.
Loading instructions. Head northwest.
Once you've selected your mapping software, Lazarillo will guide you to your location with details about intersections, turns, and distance. This feature can be used to guide users to their location safely, regardless of their familiarity with a route. If you select the bus or car button, you'll have the option to choose between a variety of mapping softwares to get your route, including Google Maps, Apple Maps, and MoveIt to travel by bus, or Google Maps, Apple Maps, and Waze to travel by car. Just select your software of choice, and Lazarillo will redirect you to a list of routes to your location. You can also use Lazarillo to quote and set up a ride to your destination through Uber by selecting the Uber button on the location screen. It allows you to view prices for different rides available through Uber and select the ride that's best for your needs. One of Lazarillo's most unique functionalities is the Favorites feature.
You are on Wickersham LN 2501, Austin TX.
Any location in the Lazarillo app can be added as a favorite, saving the location in the Favorites tab for users to revisit quickly and easily. To save a location as a favorite, simply select the Favorites button on the top corner of any location screen.
Museum, Blanton Museum of Art, 4 miles to the north.
Once a location has been saved as a favorite, you can find the location in the Favorites tab on the bottom of the home screen. You can also create a custom favorite location by selecting the Add a Favorite button in the top corner of the Favorites menu. Once you tap the button, you have the option of entering a specific address or having Lazarillo save your current GPS location as a favorite. If you select Add Favorite by GPS location, Lazarillo will identify your location using your phone's GPS technology. You can improve the accuracy of this feature by going outside or making sure that your device is connected to Wi-Fi. Once the device identifies your location, you can add a custom name, category, and description of the location to make it easier to find in the future. You can edit or delete a favorite location at any time by selecting the Edit button in the upper corner of the Favorites menu. Select the Delete button to remove the location from your Favorites menu, or the Edit button to edit the location's information. Once you select the Edit button, you can customize the location's name, category, and description. Editing favorites works a bit differently on Android than it does on iOS. Rather than the Edit button being located in the Favorites menu, on Android it's located on the location screen. Once you've added the location to your favorites, the Edit button will appear in the upper right corner of the app, between the Favorites button and the Share button. Just tap the Edit button to edit the location's information, as you would on iOS. Lastly, you can share a favorite location by selecting the location in the Favorites menu, and then pressing the Share button in the top right corner of the location screen. All of your favorites are saved to your Lazarillo account. This allows you to access your favorite list regardless of the device that you're using to access the Lazarillo app. Lazarillo's news feature allows businesses and organizations to share information with users directly in a fully accessible format. To look at your news feed, just tap the News button in the bottom menu of the app.
Tab bar, News, tab, 3 of 4.
In the News tab, you'll have access to all of the news posts that have been shared with people in your location, listed from newest to oldest, allowing you to see every important update from organizations and businesses in your area. Just tap the news post that you want to view to get started.
Increasing accessibility in Detroit. Last update 5 days ago. Read message. Selected.
In each news post, institutions can include their logo, a title, a body paragraph, and multiple calls to action.
Increasing accessibility in Detroit. This summer, Lazarillo is one of 7 companies taking part in the Accessible Street Studio, a collaboration between Ford's Michigan Central and NewLab.
You can select any of these calls to action to easily access the information that you need, from web pages to contact information to forms on which you can register for events or special offers.
Join the beta testing group today. Back button. Learn more about our work in Detroit at our website. Web page loaded.
With Lazarillo's news feature, you can have front row access to important updates from local stores, nonprofit organizations, and more, so you never miss out. The Lazarillo app has a number of customizable settings that users can adjust to fit their needs. Most of these settings are the same across platforms, but there are a few differences between the settings on Android and iOS, which I'll note throughout the tutorial. To begin, just select the Settings button in the bottom menu of the app. The first section of the Settings menu will display the username and email associated with your Lazarillo account. In the next section, you can edit your audio settings, including volume, speech speed, pitch, and your voice engine. On iOS, just move the sliders to set your preferences.
This is a test message for the current configuration.
On Android, you can change your speech speed by selecting the Speech Speed tab in the audio menu. Back on iOS, you have the option to choose from the voice engines native to your device, shown here.
This is a test message for the current configuration.
Android users can select from a menu of any of the voice engines that they've previously uploaded to their device by selecting the Voice Engine tab in the audio menu. Android users can also select whether they want to be notified when their GPS signal is lost or found by toggling the switch on the GPS Signal Announcements tab. In the Voice Announcements section, you can adjust your unit of measurement, choosing between metric and imperial, and the format of your announcements, choosing between cardinal directions, relative directions, and clock position. On Android, you can also customize how the app announces nearby intersections. Under the User Interface section, you can customize the Category section of the Exploration tab, choosing to display it as either a grid or a list. You can also select your language of choice by selecting the Change Language tab. On Android, this section also allows you to choose between dark mode, light mode, and the system default setting. On iOS, the app will automatically adapt to the mode that coincides with the settings on your device. The Miscellaneous section of the Settings tab displays information from Lazarillo, such as links to the Lazarillo website and access to the privacy policy. You can also log out in this section, allowing you to sign into the app from any account that you choose.